you know, the world of caffeine and energy drinks is kind of fits into two categories. You have people who drink coffee every day, and then you have people who drink everything else every day. And the everything else category is kind of limited because you've got energy drinks and you've got other kind of plant-based, you know, caffeine sources, but that's not really well established. You know what I mean? So what I noticed was we were buying like a case of energy drinks from Costco, like once every month. And I was drinking one in the morning every single day. And I'd go to work and do, you know, a big 6-hour open heart surgery. And at the end of that, I was exhausted. And so usually we start in the operating room at like 7:30. We're done by 12 or 1. And then you have other stuff going on. You've got, you know, clinic, or you've got, you know, patients to see in the ICU and other things like that. And I was kind of barely making it through that part of the day. And so it wasn't long before I was drinking a second energy drink in the afternoon just to kind of get through that part of it. It's not so much that it's not effective, because it is effective. You just have this feeling that, you know, this probably isn't the best thing for me. And I don't have a great scientific explanation for why an energy drink is bad for you. A lot of people have postulated, well, maybe it's because of this or that or the other. I don't have a great explanation for that, but I do know that I didn't like the fact that I was having to scale up just to maintain normal function. And so then, you know, what are you left with? You know, for people who don't drink coffee or tea or those kinds of things, you kind of have to look for something else. And as I did that, as I researched for alternatives, you know, that's where you get into this whole world of people making all sorts of things. And as you dive deeper into what is in a lot of these products, there are two kind of things I found. Number one, I found that there are popular ingredients and a lot of claims are made about those ingredients, whether it's some herb or some dried mushroom or something like that. And people will say, well, this has been used anciently to cure, you know, inflammatory diseases or whatever. And so they get piled into these products. And I had a really hard time validating any of those claims clinically. Now, granted that, you know, a lot of this stuff isn't done, like they don't have double-blinded clinical trials for the use of lion's mane mushroom on arthritis, right? That study doesn't exist, to my knowledge. But I didn't like the fact that a lot of these things were just being put into products, in my opinion, without a lot of substantiation.